Hey folks, Armin Hammer here, and this is a preview of day 4 of the Dubai CrossFit Championships. We've had 3 full days of competition, and the last day of competition, day 4, has 4 scored events on it. So we have a lot to talk about. Let's get to it. If you saw the recap that I released earlier about day 3's competition, then you probably know that day 4 has a lot of interesting races to watch, a lot of interesting spots where there's only a couple points separating places that can decide tens of thousands of dollars of prize money or even qualifying positions for the CrossFit Games. But what are the events we're gonna be seeing contested on day 4 of the Dubai CrossFit Championship? Day 4 of the DCC is gonna kick off with event 7. It's this couplet of rope climbs and handstand walks. So it's 9, 6, 3 rope climbs, and after each set, you have to do a 40 meter handstand walk, which based on the flooring that we saw at the event day 3 is essentially handstand walking from the rig to the end and back. Now on the men's side, you're gonna wanna keep an eye on 2 athletes. That's Street Horner and BKG. They're both athletes who are not just good at these individual pieces, the upper body pulling and sort of the moderate skill work of handstand walking under duress. They're actually really good at the combination of those 2 things. And I think that they're gonna be putting up, you know, really competitive times outside of, you know, obviously the Matt Frasers of the world who are going to absolutely destroy this workout. On the women's side of things, this workout has Jamie Green's name written all over it. And I suspect that she is going to really push the pace here, because the 2 people that she is competing with the most in order to get that number 1 spot, Sam Briggs, who has the number 1 spot right now, and Sarah Sigmund's daughter, who is right behind her, those are 2 athletes who won't necessarily be able to keep up with her at an event like this that has, you know, strong upper body pulling as well as that handstand walking skill under that sort of exertion that this type of a quick workout is going to require. With that in mind, I think the fastest women's time of the day is probably gonna come out of the team division if the Team Jackal elects Cassidy Lance McWhorter to actually do this workout. I think this is the perfect workout for her to really just, you know, set the tone. Event 8 is a quick, dirty, out and back style chipper. It's a sandbag carry into burpee box jump overs, into an assault bike sprint, and then into the burpee box jump overs, and then back to the sandbag carry. So we're gonna be seeing athletes really pushing the envelope here. None of these sets are big enough to slow people down if they're willing to put their pedal to the metal. And on top of that, it's not super heavy and it's not a huge amount of work. So what we're gonna see is, I think, athletes really aggressively pushing the pace on this workout. Now the team version of event 8 is very similar. It still has the sandbag carry, it still has the burpee box jump overs, it still has the assault bike, but the format's slightly different. The athletes are gonna be doing max calories on the assault bike while some pairs are doing the sandbag carry and the burpee box jump over, and they're gonna have very short periods of time in order to work. So similar idea to really pushing that high-end power output as the individuals, but shockingly, event 8 for the teams actually might require some teamwork. On the men's side of things, I think the people to watch on event 8 are gonna be Travis Mayer and Paul Castillo. These are athletes who are known for going hog on these assault bikes, on the sandbags, burpee box jump overs. These are things that for normal people would be, you know, roadblocks, and for them are merely tiny little speed bumps. For the women's division, I think we really have to watch out for both Sam Briggs and Sarah Sigmund's daughter. These are 2 athletes who are known for being able to really turn it up to 11 when they need to, and athletes who are known for really being able to get into the gym and do these types of disgusting workouts at high capacities on a regular basis. And so when you put together their penchant for actually doing this sort of thing, and also the fact that they both have something to prove in coming into this workout, I think we're gonna see some fireworks on that final heat for the women's event 8. With the team division, it would be foolish of me not to pick Invictus, which has really proven their dominance across every team event so far. I mean, these are 4 individual athletes who are super strong and really talented and work together really well in Lauren Fisher, Rasmus Anderson, Reagan Huckabee, Tommy Venus. But my heart tells me to go with Travis Williams and Team Omnicide, because I have personally seen Travis Williams go bonkers on an assault bike with no consideration for what is left in a workout that very well could have taken 20 or 25 minutes. And this is a workout that's only 3 minutes at a time. He is going to break that assault bike, or he's gonna break himself. And either way, it's gonna be really exciting to see. The last known event for the final day of competition at the 2018 Dubai CrossFit Championship is Liftoff, event 9, which is a couplet. It's 15 snatches and 15 clean and jerks for time. The snatches on the men's side, those are 90 kilos. The clean and jerks are 110 kilos. On the women's side, it's 60 kilos on the snatches and 80 kilos for the clean and jerks. So we're talking, you know, pretty moderate weight, like moderately heavy to heavy weight when you're looking at this many reps. And it's a really aggressive time cap at only 6 minutes. You may notice that I haven't mentioned Matt Fraser as a favorite to win these events, either 7 or 8 so far. And honestly, it's just really obvious to pick him to win an event like Liftoff, just as it's obvious to pick him to win any of the other events that are taking place on the last day of DCC. So just, you know, take it as an unsaid rule. Matt Fraser is probably going to win all of these events. Now, that is out of the way. Who else is gonna be able to come in and compete against him? I think the Frenchman Willie George is the man to watch in this event. I think Liftoff isn't necessarily something that's like way in his wheelhouse, but he's clearly proven that he can cycle, you know, moderate to heavy snatches and other barbell work. And he also has clearly proven that he has the capacity for that specific time domain. And I think that's what's gonna come together to you know, just put him in a position to capitalize here, especially considering he's, you know, gonna be competing against Matt Fraser and right behind him, BKG. And this isn't BKG's wheelhouse. BKG is not known for being a strong barbell cycler with these types of weights. For the women's division, this is an event that Sam Briggs is going to definitely have to try and do some damage control on, because it's not her forte to do this many reps with a heavy weight like this, especially considering her elbow was severely injured during the open, you know, training for regionals this year. So this isn't gonna be her strong suit. And I think we have to keep an eye on Sarah Sigmund's daughter. She's known for cycling a barbell, and she's known for having capacity in this specific time domain. And I think that's gonna be very, very exciting to watch. For the teams going into event 8, where they're essentially doing sort of half the work each and relaying back and forth from man to man and then woman to woman, I think it would be really silly not to point out Team Jackal. Cassie Lance McWhirter, Jen Smith, Adrian Moonweiler, Lucas Esslinger, they're super, super strong athletes. Each one of them has a capacity to really push the limit here. But also on this event, Team Omnicide, they won the snatch event. So they had the highest total pounds lifted in the snatch event among the four of them. So clearly very, very strong athletes. And I think that's going to, you know, play in their favor when you put a barbell in front of them and tell them to lift it a bunch of times. The final event of the DCC is unknown at this point. It hasn't been announced. We have no real idea of exactly how it's gonna pan out, whether every competitor is gonna do it or they're gonna cut down to a smaller field going into it. But what we do know is some of the storylines going into this last day of the Dubai CrossFit Championships. And with a spot at the CrossFit Games on the line for the individuals and for the teams, this is a really, really important moment for all of their years when it comes to the 2019 Games season. The storyline on the men's side to focus on most is, it's already kind of been answered. We've seen Matt Fraser come in at a time of year that's generally gonna be his off season, and he's sort of claimed his spot. He's already taken the first place. He has a big lead. It's very unlikely that he is going to implode to the point where he loses that lead. So really the question becomes, can, if something unlikely like that were to happen, can an athlete like Willie George or BKG capitalize on that and put themselves above Matt Fraser? Now, I don't think that is a realistic expectation. If anything, Fraser is a professional competitor. He knows exactly where he is. He knows exactly what he needs to do. He is very, very aware of where everyone else is on the floor, to the point where he's known for sort of like waving cameramen out of his way so he can keep an eye on the clock and know where to strike and speed up and slow down. And I think it is going to be a really interesting final day of competition because we're looking at a huge volume of work at a time where, again, it would generally be off season for a lot of these athletes. So what we want to see is, can all these athletes recover? And if the unlikely were to happen, can an athlete like Willie George or BKG make that moment count? The main storyline to look at on the women's side of things is whether Sam Briggs, a perennial games athlete, a former games champion, can hold on to a position that will qualify her back for the CrossFit Games as an individual in a competition where arguably two of the last four events are definitely, you know, just not in her wheelhouse. I mean, she's not going to be great on the handstand walk because of her elbow injury, and she's not going to be great with the liftoff because she's never been a heavy barbell cycling type of athlete. So with that tiny of a door open, are we going to be able to see Jamie Green or Sarah Sigmund's daughter come in and take advantage of that? Finally, we have the main storylines on the team competition. The Dubai team competition has been, in my opinion, a little hit and miss. I mean, we're seeing a lot of emphasis on individual capacity. And while one of the best things about the new game season format is that these events can kind of have whatever flavor that they want, it doesn't strike me as the best way of picking a team to compete at the games. They are having a few different team events coming in. You know, event 8 has a little bit of teamwork. Event 6 that we saw on day 3 had some teamwork involved because it was a relay. You know, I think we're starting to see some of that come into play. And what I really want to see answered, the question that I have is, can we have a group of individual athletes who don't necessarily train together? For example, Team Jackal, a group of very, very strong, very fit individual athletes who do not train together on a regular basis, can they beat out a team of athletes that do train together on a regular basis, that are able to put together, you know, actual team training sessions? And I think that is the question that's going to be answered across the entirety of the 2019 game season. I mean, we've seen Travis Williams really talk a lot of smack, especially aimed at Rich, about mayhem and the fact that the new game season is actually going to work against a team like Mayhem that trains together and works out together and really focuses on the teamwork aspect of the team competition, where, you know, Travis's opinion is that it's going to be very focused on the individual capacities of all these athletes. I'm not sure where I lie on that spectrum. I think it should be more team focused. I think so far the Dubai CrossFit Championships have been more individual focused. So I'm not 100% sure exactly where it's going to pan out. And to me, the biggest question that needs to be answered is exactly that. Are we going to be seeing teams that are excelling because their individuals are excellent? Or are we going to be seeing teams excel because they are excellent teams? There you have it, folks. That is your preview for the final day of the 2018 Dubai CrossFit Championships. If this video has seemed a little bit strange, or the previous video, the recap video, has seemed a little bit strange, let me tell you, I've been up all night watching a competition that has taken place on the other side of the world, and I am very tired. So if I'm slurring my speech or I'm rambling on and on, that's probably why. And I really appreciate you guys giving me your time and your attention. I hope that I was able to kind of get across some of the things that I'm excited to watch, and I hope you guys enjoyed this. Now, I'm gonna try and go get some sleep, but remember, folks, there's a whole lot going on in our space, and it's easy to miss some of the most interesting and exciting stories. That is what I'm here for, and I'll see you guys next. I'm just kidding. But seriously, I'm exhausted.